Here we go. Looks like I got my my first redfish here. There's this, looks like there's a school of them maybe right along the point right here. I saw some commotion in the water. It looked like maybe bait. I thought it was a big school of mullet, but I think it happened to be a school of redfish. Possibly could be a school of mullet. And this redfish was just kind of hanging behind him. But my first Port Isabel redfish since I've got back here. It's my first time out on the water. And it didn't take long. I think I've been fishing maybe about, 5-10 minutes and get on my first red. So very cool. Trying to keep my eye on that that school as it's moving around out here. Oh, nope. Come back. There we go. Okay. Cool deal. It didn't take much reviving at all. Awesome, cool. That is a good start to the day right there. Let's see if we can find some more of these guys. There we go. He hit that hard. He wanted it. So I'm starting to notice a pattern here. These fish are not in these deeper potholes. Listen to that drag sing. They're actually over these little smaller potholes that still has a little bit of grass on them. I've spooked a couple of them off, and that's exactly where they've all been. Whoa. Awesome. Let's see if we can get another one of these things. I think we've got them a little patterned out. So I'm just going to keep on drifting along here and just see if I can find these little shallow potholes that I'm seeing and see if that pattern holds true. Okay, so we ran across, we're moving up this flat, and we ran across this little shallow shoal that has all these birds working it. So what I did was I went ahead and put my anchor pin down, and I'm gonna slowly work this area. I'll pull it up, and then I'm gonna move a little bit further and slowly work the area. But one thing I don't wanna do is I don't wanna scare these birds, because if all these birds take off, and we got a black drum cruising right there, if all these birds take off, it's gonna clear out this flat. So, you know, if you run across a situation like this, definitely work this area. I'm seeing fish all over the place, whether it be mullet, baitfish activity. I just saw that black drum. So I'm gonna start working this area and see what I can come up with. There we go. I started working this outside edge on my way back. I got to my turnaround point, and I'm working this deeper water right here, and right on that pothole right there, I got this guy. Not the biggest thing in the world, but definitely fun. You know, I'd switched over to a 2.0, the Slam Shady 2.0, because I've seen a lot of fry bait, and I figured the bait's gonna be a little bit smaller, but to be honest with you, this wind picked up, and the 2.0 just wouldn't cast very well into the wind, and just didn't have enough weight to stay down. So I switched to the mulligan and was able to control it a lot better. He's a chunker. Pretty little fish there. There you go. Got me another one. I cast in that same spot. The wind had drifted me back. I think we might have a little school. It's right behind me. Hopefully we can get this guy in. Maybe find out if there is a school there. This one's a little bit better. Okay. Yeah, a little better fish. Little spot on that side. There we go. So, fishing these schools of mullet. Aw, he got off. Son of a gun. But there's a little school of mullet pushing through here. Always cast to these whenever you see them, because you never know what's going to be behind them, just kind of either milling around behind them or actually chasing them. A lot of times you'll pick up some nice fish. I want to take a minute and talk about the gear that I'm using. First off, the lure, I'm actually catching everything on that mulligan in the Slim Shady color. Got that rigged on the Haas Helix. That's a 3-aught with an 1/8 ounce. And the reason why I'm using the Helix is I'm fishing grass flat. There's a lot of weeds, so an open jig head just isn't going to work. But this is definitely getting the job done. And I'll tell you what, there's something about this mulligan. You know, we talk about, you know, having the dimples in there as far as casting distance is concerned. But another thing this thing does really well is casting into the wind. There's, you know, the dimples and the mass of the lure itself just adds that little oomph, so you can actually push the this lure right through the wind, and it does an amazing job. So anytime that you're fishing, you know, in any kind of windy condition, I definitely recommend using this. As far as the rod, I am using the Cashin the Element Inshore. As you can see right here, that is the American made rod that we do sell at the shop page. This is the 7-foot medium heavy, and I'm using this one. This one is what I call my paddle tail rod. I throw all my paddle tails, whether it be the 2.0, the mulligan, or the bomber. This is what I've been using on that, and I absolutely love this rod. It's been great. The reel is the Daiwa Fuego 3000. I've got that spooled with the Daiwa J8 the Grand and the gray color, 10-pound test, and I'm using 20-pound Andy monofilament leader, and that's been pretty much doing the same, you know, the work for everything. I've caught all the fish on that same setup. You know, I really haven't had a need to throw anything else, so that's what's getting the job done. And what I'll do is I'll put links down below if you're interested in trying any of this out, so you can just click on the link. It'll take you right to the Fish Strong page. Let's see what I got here. Not really fighting like a red. Hopefully I don't have a stingray. I do not want that. Yeah, that's a red. Nice. Right there off the corner, right there in that that little cove. There we go. Got him on the Marilure Little John. So in my gear update, I said everything was caught on the Mulligan Slam Shady, but I kept fishing on my way in and wind up catching him. So I have to change that up. There we go, got another one. All I'm doing is just drifting along this flat. Ooh, he's running towards me. Drifting along the edge of this flat because it's pretty much low tide, and this fishing all of these little inclusions that you get. Whoa. This one is a mean one. He's all over the place. But yeah, it seems like, you know, it's standard typical redfish setup. You know, whenever this the flats kind of empty off, they're not going to go very far. They're just going to go right to these drop-offs. And, and kind of hang out there until the tide starts swinging around. Whoa, I do not want you breaking my rod. Okay. There we go. Good deal. Okay, let's get you going here. Oh yeah, you can get that way down in there. There we go. That's the Marilure Little John. Got that on an 1/8 ounce open jig head. Let's go ahead and throw that out there. Here's the culprit there. That is that's a pretty fish. A better one for the day right there. Good, let him go. There we go. Cool. Let's see if he might have a friend over there. So that was the last fish of the trip, but as you can tell, that wound up being a really good day. Some good tips in the video were fishing certain types of potholes, looking for birds, and fishing the edges of the flats during the low tide. What's important to know is the current trends. In the spring, the fish are going to be on the move, so it's important that we transition from winter spots to spring spots. The best way to know the current trends is to be involved with a network of anglers that share information. So if you want to be more connected to what's currently happening, I highly recommend joining us in the Insider community, where we have tens of thousands of anglers learning and sharing valuable information. For more details, go to saltstrong.com. And if you like informative videos like this one, be sure and click the like button down below and click on subscribe so you don't miss out.